with conductive hearing loss, you have the sound that travels into the ear canal, goes to the eardrum, and before it gets to the inner ear where that organ of hearing is, there's some sort of problem that's causing that sound to need to be that much louder in order for it to get to the inner ear to hear. So it's the sound can't conduct to that inner ear. But let's say we have somebody who has fluid in their ears and we test their hearing, and when we go through headphones, the sound has to be a lot louder. But when we put a headphone that goes behind the ear and we bypass that outer and middle ear and bypass the fluid, then those scores are much better. Let's say in the normal range, that just means that the inner ear is working normally, but the sound has to be that much louder to conduct through all of that fluid per se for the patient to hear. Now with a sensorineural hearing loss, the sound goes in, and when we're testing, because that's when we're testing the hearing loss, or that we're testing the hearing for the patient, we do bone conduction and air conduction. So if the bone conduction scores match up with the air conduction scores, meaning that the sound can get to the inner ear and there's no hindrance to that sound at all of those marks will match up, and that's called a sensorineural hearing loss.